What is the flux passing through the lateral surface ABCD? Now, flux passing through the lateral surface ABCD. Now, ABCD is the lateral surface. Lateral surface. Now, here, this is called lateral surface. This is the lateral surface. This is the lateral surface. Now, at this point, what is the electric field intensity? Electric field intensity is E. Now, on the lateral surface, let us consider an unit area. Right? That small amount of area is equal to ds. Now, area vector is perpendicular, n cap. Now, we are considering lateral surface. Right? On the lateral surface, what is the electric field intensity? Electric field intensity is outward. On the lateral surface, there is an area, small area. That small area is represented by ds. Area vector is perpendicular to the area. Area vector is perpendicular to the area. Area vector is perpendicular to the area. Here is also area vector is perpendicular to the area. In this case, electric field intensity is perpendicular to the area vector, that equals to theta is equals to 90 degrees. Therefore, flux ABCD is equals to closed integral of E ds cos theta, that equals to closed integral of E ds. Here in this case, cos 90, theta is equals to 90, cos 90 is equals to 0, 0. Therefore, in this calculation, the flux passing through the circular surface AB is ES. The flux passing through the circular surface CD is again ES. The flux passing through the ABCD lateral surface is 0. Therefore, what is the total flux? What is the total flux? Phi is equals to flux passing through AB plus flux passing through CD plus flux passing through lateral surface ABCD. Now, that is flux is equals to AB. AB is equals to ES. AB is equals to ES. Flux passing through the CD is also equals to ES plus flux passing through the lateral surface 0. Therefore, flux is equals to, that is 2ES. Now, this is the total flux. Now, according to Gauss law, now what is the Gauss law? This is the Gauss law. According to the Gauss law, flux is equals to Q by epsilon naught. Q by epsilon naught. What is the total flux we calculated? 2ES. Therefore, 2ES is equals to Q by epsilon naught. That implies E is equals to Q by, that is 2 epsilon naught into S. Therefore, E is equals to Q by S into 2 into epsilon naught. That implies E is equals to Q by S. Q by S is equals to surface charge density by epsilon naught. Therefore, what is the electric field intensity? E is equals to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Therefore, what is our topic? Electric field intensity due to the infinite charged sheet. Now, this is called infinite charged sheet. Now, because infinite charged sheet is the two-dimensional object, on the two-dimensional object, the charge is distributed. In this case, you want to define a physical quantity, surface charge density, sigma is equals to Q by S, charge per unit area. Charge per unit area is called surface charge density. Now, let us consider, what is the electric field intensity at a point with respect to the infinite charged sheet? For this one, you want to consider a Gaussian cylinder. That Gaussian cylinder is, what do you say, it is taking place in horizontal direction named by ABCD. Again, the Gaussian cylinder is represented by, right, AB is the circular surface, CD is the circular surface, and ABCD is the lateral surfaces. There are three surfaces, out of which two are the circular surface, next one is the lateral surface. Right? Calculate the flux passing through the circular surfaces as well as the lateral surface. Now, what is the flux passing through the circular surface AB? Now we calculated as a ES. What is the flux passing through the CD circular surfaces? It is calculated as ES. Now what is the flux passing through the lateral surface? Now flux passing through the lateral surface is zero. Now that what is the total flux passing through the cylinder? Therefore total flux is equals to phi of AB plus flux passing through the AB, flux passing through the CD, flux passing through the ABCD. Flux passing through the AB, that equals to ES. Flux passing through the CD, that equals to ES. Flux passing through the ABCD lateral surface is equals to zero. Therefore flux is equals to 2ES. Now in order to calculate electric field intensity, you want to apply the Gauss law. What is the Gauss law? That is, the flux passing through any closed surface is equals to 1 by epsilon naught times to the net charge. Already, what is the total flux we calculated? 2 into ES. Therefore, flux is equals to 2 into ES by Q by epsilon naught. Therefore, E is equals to Q by 2S. That is 2 into epsilon naught is here, S is here. Now after rearranging Q by S, after rearranging Q by S into by 2 epsilon naught. Now Q by S, the charge per unit area is termed as surface charge density. Therefore E is equals to Q by S, that is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Therefore with respect to the infinite charged sheet, the electric field intensity is equals to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Sigma by 2 epsilon naught.